Project 52 is produced by the East Oakland Times.
This first piece is it's just a story, and it's really about my journey. It's called Where Did the Love Go? And it goes like this. By all accounts, when I was a toddler, I was much more than just a whippersnapper. I was a confident little boy with a ravenous hunger for life. I was super cute. Nothing's changed there.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded.
And a bit of a ham. I was exuberant, boisterous, inquisitive, and at times rambunctious. All of the things a little boy is supposed to be. My favorite things were to dance and sing to all kinds of music. No changes there either. So, it's funny, my mom still has a picture of me at 3 years old, naked as a jaybird, wearing only an enormous pair of black headphones over my white blonde bowl cut, while clutching in both hands the sleeve from the Muppet movie soundtrack on vinyl, with my brow lifted and eyes wide with raw emotional intensity, and my mouth agape in glorious harmony with Kermit, as I belted out my favorite track, The Lovers, The Dreamers, and Me. I was chock full of awe and wonder. Fascinated by it all, I soaked up life like a sponge. I had fantastic dreams and incredible aspirations. I had a limitless imagination and unwavering belief in myself, that I could do anything and be anyone I wished. I lived every moment to its fullest potential. I loved unabashedly and completely and without fear of rejection, abandonment, or betrayal. It was a magnificent existence. And then, as life dealt out its winnings and losses, its victories and its defeats, and its peaks and valleys came my way, for some reason I became afraid. Afraid of everything. Afraid of failure and of success. Afraid of ignorance and of wisdom. Afraid of being lied to. Afraid of being told the truth. Afraid of being different. Afraid of being the same. Afraid of blazing my trail. Afraid to follow in the footsteps of another. Afraid to commit to something that was working. Afraid to cut my losses and let go of something that wasn't. Afraid to fall too hard in love, and deathly afraid of never falling in love at all. So, driven by fear, I hid from it all in drugs. For me, drugs were not an escape. For when I think of escape, I think of safety as the end result. No, for me, drugs were just a hole in which to crawl into and hide as life paraded right on by. You see, I'm coming to see that my life isn't defined by what happens to me. It's defined by how I react to what happens to me. Some things happened to me when I was a child that I reacted to by becoming afraid of love. I became afraid to love and afraid to be loved. And since love is the very essence and meaning of life, I was afraid of life itself. Think about it. Love is what propels us. It's what inspires us. It's the only reason we do anything. Ultimately, we do things because of love, or we don't do things because of fear. Whether you love cooking or skiing or reading or shopping or surfing or painting or singing or skydiving or dancing or fly fishing or unicycling, or you love photography or chess or poetry or music or poker or art or language or travel or hula hoop or hot yoga, or you love cars or shoes or jewelry or tools or boats or clothes or electronics or widgets or Weeble Wobbles or Beanie Babies, or you love your girlfriend or your boyfriend or your dog or your mom or your dad or your friends or your children or your Uncle Larry, or that girl across the room with the most amazing smile you've ever seen, or that girl that just stepped from your dreams to serve you your iced skinny mocha latte. These are the reasons we get up in the morning. Our only permanent goal is to figure out what we love and then spend as much time as possible amidst those things. So you see, it all boils down to love. And as I said, I was afraid of love. Afraid that eventually, no matter what, the things I love would hurt me, would let me down. And you know what? Sometimes they will. But even if they do, every single time, I don't care at all anymore. I'm sick and tired of running away from love. I'm fed up with hiding away from life. In fact, if it has to be, then I'm looking forward to having my heart ripped from my chest and squeezed and crushed and stomped on so that I can get up and do it all over and over and over again until one day I'm sure the planets and stars and moon will align at just the right trajectory and I'll find that genuine, no-holds-barred, in-it-for-the-long-haul agape love. Whoa, wait. What's that feeling? Could it have been right here inside me all along? I don't know, but I know one thing for sure. Today, right now, I feel like that butt-naked 3-year-old little boy again, grooving to the lovers, the dreamers, and me without a care or concern in the world and with only 3 questions on my mind. What's next, where's next, and who's next? That's the end of number 1. The second thing I have is a poem. And this poem is called Face Her. And it goes like this. Love is a simple thing. She is forward, blunt, and brutally honest. She speaks her mind. She holds nothing back. She puts it all out on the table. You'll know these that are in her favor by their radiant glow, and those that are not by their dreary wilt. Love is an intense thing. She is a force to be reckoned with, and she will be. No one escapes her clutches. She lives in everlasting infamy. She's a legend, a titan, a juggernaut, a goddess. She is immortal. Love is a wild thing. She cannot be tamed or muted. She's a hurricane, a tornado, a tidal wave. She alone chooses her path, and you're better off riding her out than fighting against her. Denying her is futile, a lost cause. If you don't allow her to swallow you whole, she'll chew you up and spit you out. Love is a crazy thing. She is your creator, and she is bent on your destruction. She is a paradisiacal hell on earth. She'll make you feel powerful, like you could part seas and move mountains. She'll make you feel helpless, like a crying infant abandoned in the dead of night. She'll make you want to sing, dance, jump for joy, and shout her praises from the highest rooftops. She'll make you want to dive off the Golden Gate Bridge or leap from atop the Empire State Building. She is a good luck charm and a foreboding omen, a four-leaf clover and an albatross. She's a most generous philanthropist and an armed robber, a thief in the night. She is demanding and forgiving. She is plain and humble and intricate and flamboyant. She needs everything right now and wants nothing at all, ever. If you search for her, she can be elusive and evasive, hard to catch. Or when you least expect it, she may suddenly kick in your front door or stealthily climb in your rear window. She's a brazen strategic mission and an impulsive clandestine tryst. She's a fleeting, fickle, stuck-up bitch, and she's your truest friend, your most salacious lover, your faithful wife, and the mother of your children. She's an entirely random event and the most difficult choice you'll ever have to make. Love is every bit of all of these things. How will you react to her? Will you face her with bravery and courage, take your lashes and beatings, dust yourself off, wipe the sweat from your brow, and while wearing your scars as a flag, charge back into glorious battle in hopes of tasting the sweet nectar of victory and plundering her treasures and riches? Or will you build a fortress in which to barricade yourself, or dig a hole to crawl into so as to hide in a deep, damp, dark, lonely place from the very essence and meaning of life? The end.
Project 52 is produced by the East Oakland Times.